Hi everyone, thank you so much for joining me today. Before I get started, first of all, I want to say welcome to all of my new subscribers. I know I have many, and I would just like to say welcome, and I hope you enjoy it here. The other thing I wanted to mention, particularly because I received a few comments, emails, whatever, just saying if I knew what was going on in the world just because I kept on with my videos. And I think that if you've been with me for a while, you know that the way I cope with whatever situation, and whether it was the heartbreaking situation that I went through in October, or it's this that is affecting all of us around the world, I deal with it by being here in my makeup. In my makeup room, by playing with makeup. I apply makeup every single day. I wear a wig every single day, and that's the way I cope. I also wanted to make sure that you knew that I am not coming on here to try to sell you anything. If I'm showing you today neutral palettes, it's just that. It's just showing you some neutral palettes. If one of my friends came over, or my girls came over, my nieces, family, we always end up in my makeup room and we start going through palettes and we go through foundations and blushes and lipsticks, we go through it all. And I feel that is the same thing I'm doing here with you. Just my friends coming over for a visit and I'm just showing you some palettes. I will certainly list them down below if they are still available in case anybody wants one. But please know that I am here basically to try to distract both you and me, and you get what I'm saying, right? You get it. All right, let's get to it. I'm going to start off with what I am wearing today, and that is the palette by Dominique Cosmetic. This is the first one. This is the latte palette. I really wanted to just share with you my favorite neutral palettes. Now, granted, what might be neutral for one is not neutral for the other, but nevertheless, I think this is a neutral palette. So play with me. Okay. Dominique Cosmetics Latte, like I said, this is what I'm wearing. And when you first look at this palette, it looks, okay, Marlene, there's colors there. Yeah, okay. But if we cover those up, you see how neutral they are? And then we just have a few pops of color. Not anything drastic, just this purple right here and this blue that could be added to the outer V or on the lower lash line if that's something that you wanted to do. This is a beautiful, beautiful palette. I absolutely love it. I have worn it often. And to me, I have everything I need right here. Do I? Yeah, because it's a nice mixture of mattes and shimmers. This is a really old palette. I think this is one of my first palettes that I purchased. And this is by Too Faced. It's called the mattes, I think it is. I'm having a really hard time opening palettes. Okay. This is called the Matte Eyes. I don't know if this is still even available, but when I was picking out my favorite neutral palettes, what I did, I looked to see which were the palettes that I reach for the most when I just wanted to do a neutral look. And this one is one of them. This does not have a mirror. I think the first one, I can't remember if the first one was one of those little metal palettes or if it was this one. Either way, it's changed one way or another. Neutral, beautiful, just what you need. If you like just if you like just mattes and a very neutral eye and you don't like any type of color, really, the only thing that is color, if you will, is this shade right here, which is a mauve. Very, very light. I'll swatch it for you so you could see it. It's almost like a, more like a taupe. You see that? It's a very cool, I think that's cool, very cool, between a purplish and a gray. I think it's such a pretty color. And I think that this is the only palette where I have that shade. The next palette, I think it's probably one of, no, it's not my newest, but it's in the newer collection, and it's the Going Coconuts palette. This is a very affordable palette. I can't remember how much it was, $9, $12, something like that. But if you like neutral shades, this is a really nice palette to use. This is a kind of a grab and go palette. You have your six mattes, you have three over here and you have three here, and then you have your shimmers going right down the middle. The only one I'm really not crazy about too much is this white one, that white one right there. However, I have used it like in the inner corner just a little bit, or just a little dab right under my brows. Another one that if you just need a neutral in your collection, if you're, you know, just one of those palettes that you just want to grab and go, especially now that so many have to be doing conferencing from home, or you're working from home and you have to do conferencing. This is a nice palette, very inexpensive. I just swatched a couple of the shimmers so you could see, and it's a wonderful quality. Smooth and creamy, blendable, very nice. Just as I have so many ColourPop palettes, and I cannot say enough about them. This is one of my favorite palettes all around, just all around. So much so that I have a backup for it. There are two palettes that I have a backup for, and one is the Naked 3 palette, and that I showed in my Timeless, the Test of Time video. I love that palette, and I think if you saw that video, you know that was my backup. The other palette that I have a backup is my Persona Identity palette. This is the first one. There are two. There's the Identity 1 and the Identity 2. I have them both, but this is the one that I really, really like. When Sona Gasparian launched this, it was marketed as for brown eyes. And if you know Sona, she is a younger girl here on YouTube. I don't know how old she is, maybe in her mid-30s. Beautiful, I believe she's Armenian. Beautiful, beautiful, young, sweet girl. And she developed this palette. This palette is, well, I have a backup for it. And you know that if I have a backup for it, you know that I love it. The shimmers are so incredibly smooth and so beautiful. I have gone on travel, because there's also mattes in here. I've gone on travel and I've only taken that palette. If I was leaving like for 2 or 3 or 4 days and I could only take one palette, it'd be hard to pick between this one and my Naked 3, because I love it so much and it lasts for hours. The formula in this palette is incredible. Love this one. This palette I've had for a really long time. When my brother went to Europe, he bought me a great big box filled with lots of makeup. At that point that he bought it back for me, I did not have any Zoeva. I had never tried it. I wanted some. And he was going, in his travels, he was going to go to the UK. And I asked him if he came across any Zoeva to bring it for me. So he bought me two palettes. He bought me the set of brushes and lipsticks. In that Test of Time video, again, I showed the Dior that he bought me. But one of the palettes that he bought back was this one. And this is the Nude Spectrum from Zoeva. This is another very reasonable brand. I love Zoeva. I think I have all of the Zoeva palettes or close to it. There is no mirror. It's a cardboard case. Beautiful, beautiful shades that are neutral. You get a black. You have a nice brow shade up here. And the shimmers are very subtle shimmers. They are not in your face type of shimmers. They're not like it's going to blind anybody looking at you from the moon or anything like that. These are just three of the shades. They sheer out really nicely. They last long. It's just a beautiful, beautiful palette. Even if you don't wear makeup very often, this is a very, it's a user-friendly palette. Very simple to use because the shades just blend so well. Love that palette. And like I said, it's very reasonable. It's under $30, if I remember correctly, here in the States anyway. This is, I love this palette. I purchased this palette back in the summer of last year. And I purchased it because I had just heard about Alter Ego. I was in Kansas and I had taken the Huda Nudes with me. I cannot take all of my palettes when I go to spend the 6 months in Kansas. But this, the Huda palette was one of the palettes that I took with me. And when I saw the Alter Ego palette, I thought, I'm going to try that one. And I did one eye with the Alter Ego, and I did the other eye with the Huda palette. It looked exactly the same. It lasted as long. It blended the same eye. Honestly, there was actually no difference to me whatsoever. I grab the Daydream palette from Alter Ego almost, I think I grab it more than I grab the one from the Huda palette. I don't know what it is, if it's how incredibly smooth and velvety the shadows are. If you like the Huda palette and the new Nudes palette and you just didn't want to splurge the money for it, this one, I believe it's about $16. Beautiful. Every single shade in here, just absolutely gorgeous. The shimmers, the glitters, I just think it's so incredibly pretty. And I know some people may say, let me just show you real quick. Some people may say, well, that's not a neutral palette. Well, yeah, for me it is. For me, bright shades in the yellows and the greens and the blues, those are the ones that are not neutral. But honestly, come on, let me know. Don't you agree that those can go for neutral? I mean, I think that what's neutral to one person may not be neutral to another. So play along. This is a neutral palette for me. This palette, I can't remember if I bought it 1 year ago or 2 years ago. Might have been two, I can't remember. Anyway, it's from NARS. When I purchased this palette, I could not put it down. I loved it so much. So much so, this is Summer Lights. And then I have Hot Nights or Hot Lights or something like that. I couldn't put this palette down. It has got to be one of my favorite palettes from NARS. And I know that it's probably not going to say much in the pan there, but these shadows work so beautifully. You do get a highlight and you get a bronzer, but you can use those as shadows. They're not shimmers, they're silky. Beautiful. Absolutely gorgeous. Very subtle shades. They won't show up on my hand. I did some self-tanning. I don't know if you can tell. But anyway, I don't even know if this is still available. It might not be, but because it's one of my favorite neutral palettes, I just had to include it. Like I said, I have the other one. The other one is very similar to this one, but it also has a purple in it. Of course, I can't do a favorite neutral palettes without including Viseart. This is the Neutral Mattes palette. I've had this palette for quite a while, and I use it all the time. I have it. This is one of the palettes that I have right on my makeup table. And the reason that I use it so much is because, let me show you, I just swatched three of them. Very pigmented. If you're familiar with Viseart, this is no different than any of the other ones. The nice thing about this one is that it's all matte. It is 12 shades. If you have a palette, like I have a few palettes that are just shimmer, and this is a great pairing palette, but it's also a really nice palette to just to use by itself, especially if you do not like shimmers. This is perfect. If you don't like to have a lot of palettes, you don't want to have a lot of palettes, and you want one really good one, I think this is a great one to have. Love it. I have a few of these, and actually, I don't pay full price for them. What I do, because these can be a little pricey, if you ever want to look for Viseart, sign up for their emails. I think I think I got three of these. They're regularly, I think, like $80. And I purchased three of them for, I think it was $120. And what I did in Christmas, they had that offer. And I've seen it like 2 years now where they do an offer of three palettes for $120, for example. Well, that's a huge savings when these are like $80 each. I think I saw another site too, and now I can't remember which one it was, where they were incredibly less. Anyway, moving on. LA Girl Pro Mastery Palette. I love this palette. Absolutely love it. Once again, just like the Daydream Palette, this is basically mauves and pinks. To me, that is a neutral palette because it doesn't have a lot of shocking shades in it. You could do a very subtle look. And the nice thing about this too is that if you need to go from a day look to a night look, this palette will do it for you. You could do just one or two shadows. You could do just mattes. You could mix your mattes and shimmers. And it's from the drugstore. I love LA Girl. I think their shadows are absolutely gorgeous. I love their staying power. I love their formula, how well they blend. And even if you just use a one shadow look, you could make it a little bit darker. You could sheer it out a little bit more, and that's it. That's all you need. And then take another shade and just dab it around on your lower lash line. Love it. Absolutely love it. I can't leave out my Lorac Mega Pro palette. This has very loved. I don't know if the camera's going to pick up how dirty it is, and that's because this is one of the other palettes that I always keep on my makeup table. All neutral palette, neutral shades. The only one that is kind of like the sore thumb, that the one that's sticking out, is this one. When this palette launched, I remember people saying, Why did Lorac include that pink in there? I don't know why they included it, but nevertheless, I love this palette. You have your first two rows up here are all mattes, and then you have your two bottom rows, which are, there's really no, there are a couple of shimmers. There are also some satins. Not everybody likes Lorac, Marlene. Not everyone likes Lorac. And I love it. Beautiful, beautiful shades. I love that palette. You could do so many looks with that. I mean, look at all the shades. There are 32 shades in this palette. So yeah, you could do a lot of looks with it. I have all the Mega palettes, the Mega 1, 2, and 3, I guess. And this is my favorite one of them all. Now, this one is an honorable mention. Yes, you know, I have to have an honorable mention. And this is by C Color Cosmetics. This is a golden palette. I think this palette is like $6 or $8. But oh my gosh, I have used this so much. Love it. Absolutely love it. If we cover here, but if we cover these, you see how it looks more neutral, and then you could just use these two right here as a pop of color. Such a pretty palette, and they work so well. I mean, you never be able to tell by looking at it on your eyes or how they blend or how long they wear that this is. I would have probably paid three times as much for the quality of these. All right. Those are the palettes, my favorite neutral palette. Before I leave, I do want to say that I hope that you are all safe. I'm not going to go on a spiel here because you know how to stay safe, but I hope that everyone is. I mean, we know that we have to wash our hands and everything else and be careful with the packages that arrive and staying the 6 feet away. We all know that. And I hope that you are staying positive during this time. I know it's difficult, but worrying isn't really going to get us anywhere. Sitting in front of the news for hours on end is not going to get us anywhere. And that's just my opinion. There's no fact behind that. What I do is I just get the news from my husband. He turns it on for about 10 or 15 minutes, and then he turns it off. That's it. and I try to remain focused, take a walk around the block a couple of times, run up and down the stairs, play with my makeup, talk on the phone, FaceTime with my girls. And that's what I try to, I watch the videos, cooking videos, and try to come up with new dishes. And that's what I've been doing. And it hasn't been that difficult for me, but I'm a homebody. Anyway, you be safe, stay positive. We'll get through this. We just have to hang in there. And hopefully, if we follow all directions, then maybe we could flatten out that curve. All right, everyone. Thank you so much for being here with me. Thank you for all of your support. And don't forget, ladies, follow your passion, whatever it may be. I'll see you next time. Bye.